Let me know when you guys can hear me. Check, 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 check. Hopefully this shit is gonna work this time. Hello, hello, hello. Someone give me a fucking heads up. We need to make sure that this video is not over 2 hours. Because last night I recorded my stream. It was like 2 hours and 20 minutes. And it fucking, when it was done, it didn't go into my video. It's too hard to explain for people that don't YouTube. Basically, I have my big list of videos. And because the live stream was so long last night, it went to like a special section. So it's really, you know, a pain in the ass to fucking try to manage that. So, hopefully this will be under 2 hours. That's my goal. What we're going to do here is, for the bucks, I decided just to do this for a live stream because I said as soon as like these videos hit 400 likes, I will do the next one. I have a couple, like the Eagles one scheduled for next week, but I just thought spur of the moment. Plus, there's some stuff involving my name going around right now on the YouTube, which I will address right at the top of this. But for the context of the video, we are doing the greatest players on the history of the Tampa Bay Bucks in Madden, going all the way back to Madden 99 to Madden 17. We put them all in one roster, and what we're going to do is do a one-off video. I'm pretty sure I'll send it like week 8, and then from then on, I'll play the divisional rivals, and then hopefully we'll make the playoffs, and we'll play that for the gameplay. And yeah, there's all those players there. But I assume I should start by addressing the stuff that's going on, and it's really nothing at all. It's never been anything, but I guess let's just go from the beginning, because it seems like I was at my girlfriend's house, so I wasn't really seeing. He made video. Bengal is the guy who I guess we have this big major fucking YouTube beef between our fairly small ass channels. He made like a satirical video. And then he did like a follow-up video, and he said some stuff in his live stream yesterday. It just seems like there's a lot of, I haven't seen any of these things, to be honest. I watched actually his, the clearing the air, I guess, video that he reported or whatever, fucking made. And it was accurate, but I want to share my side of the story just so you guys can hear, because it seems like, obviously, there's two sides to every story. What he said was, essentially brass tacks, what he said was true. But there are people of Bengals supporters that aren't mine that, thank you, Patrick, for the donation, by the way. There are supporters of Bengal who don't know what is, my side of things. So here's everything. It's pretty much, maybe a little bit of rinse and repeat what he said earlier. But this is it. Like, this is the only time I'm going to talk about it, because first and foremost, there's zero beef whatsoever. So essentially, people are like, oh, he stole rebuilds and all that stuff, which is the context, I guess, if you're trying to attack me or make me look like a bad guy, or even one of us to look like a bad guy in this whole scenario, because it's really not that case, because it's just a bunch of, tongue-in-cheek, not super serious, doing stuff like that. So basically, when I was on YouTube, I've been on YouTube for 5 years. I've been up and down. We've had good videos. We've had bad videos. I've been around for a long time. I started doing YouTube in end of 2011, beginning of 2012. So I've been here for a long fucking time. And when I was doing my Madden videos for this year in Madden 17, I was growing really, really big. I had like 12,000 before it started. I get up to 18,000. But then one day in my suggested videos, I saw something that was called a rebuild. And these videos were getting a fuck ton of views. And I guess what should be stated before is I didn't see a Bengal video first. There's this dude named Jerome PKR. He was the first guy that I clicked and I saw a rebuild video. I was like, oh. Why is it, like, he had half as many subscribers as me, but his videos was doing great. They're getting, a lot more views in relation to his subscribers. Like, what the fuck? These things are popular. And then he has a buddy named Bengal. And I was like, oh, shit, this guy's video is getting a little bit more traction. Well, there's the same kind of type of video. And I'm not going to outright in this kind of explanation bash their type of videos the way that they do it. But it's very similar. And I assume that if you look around the rest of YouTube, people that do rebuilds, they have the same kind of exact format. They try to acquire as many first-round picks as possible. They try to make a lot of player-for-player trades. Just get the highest overall team as quick as possible. And I was like, man, I mean, if these videos are doing so well, maybe I could get on this action. I mean, the whole thing, I guess I could start with saying I stole his video. No one owns the right to end. Saying I stole a rebuild, I got his format based off of, like, that group of people. But, no one owns any content here on YouTube. Especially something like that. Like, rebuilds have been going on forever. Oh, I did rebuilds back in 2012. You just didn't title it a rebuild. Anytime you took a shit franchise. I remember in Madden fucking 15 maybe, I took over the Oakland Raiders, and it was a rebuild of that franchise. So, I mean, it's been around forever, but I will say that I styled after him and that Jerome guy's format, for sure, because they had one-hour-long videos, and they're like, all right, here's how you do it. Here's how they were formatting it. That's pretty much the only thing I took inspiration or stole from him. But my opinion was that all the popular rebuilds are all being made the same way. So I figured, let's try and make something a little bit more realistic in relation to the other rebuilds. It's not realistic in the aspect of that is how this rebuild is happening. It's how a rebuild would really happen in real life. Because that would not be able to be done in an hour-long video. A rebuild like that would be, that's a series. That's a 30-part series or something like that. So my rebuilds, the tag rebuild, comes from, in relation to the rest of the kind of content around here. To say that I steal his idea for that is our videos are nothing to like. I didn't want to do the player for player trades. If I was doing the exact same thing and my videos were being a little bit more popular and I was doing, you know, I'm trading for all the players, I'm trying to basically get the highest overall team as quickly as possible, hell yeah, I was stealing this thing. What I do is a much slower approach. I use real rookies every single time, college players. That's the one reason why I enjoy doing it, is because I want to be able to play with a bunch of the rookies anymore, because of fucking the old Bannon lawsuit made me so I can't play NCAA anymore. And I also want to actually play with the teams. You know, what we do is, you know, what I want to do is I actually want to get some gameplay with the teams that I build, not just do the Super Sim. So those two things are highly, highly important in the way that I do my rebuilds, and they don't do it. So there's a clear line where the difference of rebuilds there. So basically one day he sent me a message asking to do a collab on Twitter, and I declined. I strictly said that I don't want to come off like a dick, bud, but I've never really collabed with anyone. I've been doing YouTube for 5 years. It's, I don't know, like I said, if you looked at my report card as a kid, it says I do not play well with others. So it's no shot at you. I just don't like doing a collab. And he seemed cool with that. He was like, all right, cool, man, maybe we could do something down the line. I said, yeah, sure. So that kind of debunks the underlying factor where people are saying, oh, Bengals just salty because I didn't want to work with them. No, not the case at all. He was cool with me saying that, and I just made sure that I didn't come off like a dick. I wasn't trying to fucking, you know, no, I'm not working with you. I hate you, or anything like that. Everything was cool on that front. There's nothing going on there. The only real interaction aside from that I had was during my live stream yesterday. People were saying, like, oh, yeah, Bengals doing a live stream right now. He called you a faggot and said you stole his idea. And those aren't his exact words. I haven't seen this live stream. I haven't watched or anything like that. So it's all hearsay. And I was just like, because of that, I had to think. I was like, what the fuck should I say about this guy? Like, I can't let, if he's, that's actually what he's saying, I should probably chirp in a little bit. But it was all just retaliation to what he was saying. And it basically, he hit me up after all this stuff went down and said it was, you know, he was joking and all that stuff. And it was the same thing with me. It was all just sarcastic banter. Nothing was personal, no personal attacks, nothing like that. So it seems after all that message and stuff on Twitter, it got all cleared up. The only thing that I didn't mention about anything that with him was it seemed like he wanted a lot of clarification on the things that I said during my live stream, which is, I mean, fair for him, if you want to really kind of see where I was coming from. But I didn't ask him about anything he said about me or didn't say, because that's the only difference right now with this whole fictitious beef that's going on, is that he seemed to be, he wants some clarification, where I have always had the stance, I don't give a fuck. Like, I hate doing this. I just want to play Madden right now. I don't want to explain this, but I know the comment section and stuff would just be fucking unbearable going on with the stuff, because there's nothing there. But that was the only real difference, is that he seemed like he wanted clarification, and not necessarily explanations or anything like that. He just kind of asked me about, you know, what I was saying, and I didn't say a damn thing, because I don't give a fuck. That is the be-all, end-all of this, is I don't give a fuck. And then in regards to the video that he did today, he let me know about it beforehand. Hell, I was even giving him some suggestions to make the video a little bit funnier. Maybe like butchering the way I say Malik and all that stuff. So all that stuff, I'm fine with it. It's satirical. Hell, when I did my first rebuild, the Lamar Jackson Miami Dolphins one, my most popular one, I fucking took a little bit of a shot at him in the opening of the video. I was like, hey guys, it's C4 here, and today we're doing a rebuild. Like, you know, it's just, why, if I got upset about him doing something like that, which I never would have, I'd be pretty hypocritical considering that I have taken my own kind of tongue-in-cheek shots at him. So, end of the day, zero beef whatsoever. Nothing's going on. This is literally the last time, hear that, the last time I will talk about any of this bullshit. I don't know if he's going to, you know, want to make something else or carry it on, but I think it's good as dead. Nothing's going on. And he actually wanted to collab in the future on potentially a draft video. I don't know if that's going to happen or not, but, you know, I'd never say never on something like that. But there. That is done. If anyone needs to get any explanations or shit like that, We can do that. But that's it. So now let's play some fucking Madden. Jesus Christ, I'm all about the Madden. I ain't about any of that drama bullshit. Like, you watch, you know, all the other Call of Duty YouTubers and all Drama Alert and all that stuff. That stuff's just absolute ass. So there's never going to be getting in stuff like that. So let's now take a quick look at the rosters. At the quarterback spot, we have Jeff Garcia, who we already saw with the Cleveland Browns. He just bounced around from team to team. Had a very sexy overall. Let me actually get my numbers here real fucking quick. So in Madden 2009, Jeff Garcia had a 90 overall rating. It bumps up to a 91 here with the scheme fit. The only other honorable mention was Brad Johnson, the quarterback that led them to the Super Bowl, who in Madden 2005 had an 87. But we'll be using Jeff Garcia once again, and hopefully he can lead us to similar success that we had with the Tampa Bay Bucks. At the running back spot, we have Doug Martin, who his current Madden 17 rating started off as a 90. It goes up to a 91 in the scheme. So he is statistically the highest overall running back that the Bucks ever had, and he's currently on the roster. The second running back we have is Carnell Cadillac Williams, who had Madden 2007, had a 90 overall. Shout out to everyone that remembers Cadillac Williams. I remember he was a beast for, I don't know, only like a year or two. It seemed like he kind of fills it off near the end. But those will be our two running backs. Fullback, we have Mike Allstott, who in Madden 2000, at the fullback position, 100 overall. I hate that we can't have 100 overalls anymore, but Allstott was the man. I mean, I was talking with some dude on Twitter who asked, you know, thanks for doing the, obviously he's a Bucks fan, thanks for doing the Bucks live stream. I sent him a picture. I have a Mike Allstott jersey hanging up on the wall that I call the GOAT wall, which currently has Ben Roethlisberger, Mike Allstott, Ray Lewis, and Adrian Peterson's jersey chilling up there. So, you know, I've always been a big fan of Allstott. And best believe the C4 special for this episode may be the inside fullback dive. Now taking a quick look at the wide receivers, Keyshawn Johnson will be leading the core, who in Madden 2002 had a 92 overall, jumps up to a 93 in this scheme. I've never been a huge fan of Keyshawn because his fucking sideline or whatever analysis that he does. I don't know, who's he with, ESPN or something? He always kind of shits on the Eagles, so fuck that guy. But he's definitely one of the better wide receivers the Bucks have ever had. We also have Mike Evans, who will be using his current overall rating. I think he's a 90. I mean, in the scheme, he jumps up to a 93, so that's very good. I don't really know why some schemes give you, like, a 3-point bump. I can see, like, a 1-point fluctuation on either side, but a 3-point bump is kind of ridiculous. And then we have Vincent Jackson, who in his year, over from the San Diego Chargers free agency. In Madden 25, he had a 92 overall, and he comes up to a 93 in the scheme. Honorable mentions were Keenan McCardell, who in Madden 2005 had an 89, and Joey Galloway, who in Madden 2007 had an 89 as well. At the tight end spot, another Brown that we're going to be featuring in this video, Kellen Winslow, the second. We already saw Jeff Garcia in the Browns video. Now we have Kellen Winslow, who in Madden 10 was a 90 overall tight end. So hopefully we can do some magic with him. The left tackle spot, we have Derek Adisi, I believe, Deese, who in Madden 2005 had an 89 overall. I'm not super sure really who the fuck this guy is, to be completely honest with you. It looked like he was one of those guys that, like, was good somewhere else and then eventually came to the Bucks near the end of his career and kept a fairly high rating. Looking at the left guard spot, we have Carl Nix, who in Madden 2013 had a 97 overall, so it's staying there. I remember him more with the New Orleans Saints. I'm pretty sure he was an all-pro with the Saints before he hit free agency and went to the Bucks, so that's why his rating's fairly high. At the center spot, we have this guy named Jeff Christie, who in Madden 2002 had a 90 overall. Again, I have no idea who the fuck this guy is. I just assume he was part of that Bucks Super Bowl team. Right guard, we have Davin Joseph, who in Madden 2009 had a 93 overall. Isn't he dead? Rest in peace. Is Davin Joseph? I remember someone that was on the Bucks in their prime died somewhat tragically, somewhat recently. I don't know if this is the guy or not, but, you know, whatever. He's a nice little guard that we have here. And then at the right tackle spot, we have current right tackle on the Bucks, Damar Dotson. However, in Madden 2015, he had an 85 overall, and it shoots up to an 87 in this scheme. Talking on the defensive side of the ball, at left defensive end, we have Michael Johnson, who literally spent like two seasons here at the best, who in Madden 15 had a 91 overall after he had a pretty big season with the Bengals and went to free agency. And then at the right defensive end spot, the beast. Here we go. Here's some goats that we see. Simeon Rice, who in Madden 2004 had a 97 overall. He literally played everywhere. I remember like near the end of his career. Like, I always thought like Simeon Rice somehow like played one season in the XFL or something crazy like that. Yeah, Simeon Rice is a beast and definitely was a guy that used to, back in the NFL 2K5 days, he'd be a guy you'd want to make sure you could use her on the D-line. The defensive tackle spots, we have maybe, I don't know if you consider him the GOAT, of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, but he certainly might have claim to that. That's Warren Sapp, who in Madden 2002 and across multiple editions of Madden had a perfect 99 overall. He's always been one of my favorite cards. I remember for what little Ultimate Team I played, I played Ultimate Team with NCAA 14, and I was like, the only good card I ever got was Warren Sapp's Miami card. And I think it was like 93, 94. But yeah, that's beast. And then we have Gerald McCoy, who's currently on the team, but in Madden 15, he had a 95 overall, and he jumps up to a 96 in this scheme. So our front four here is going to be fairly good. And that's even before we jump in to the rest of the guys that make up the front seven. So at left outside linebacker, he played right outside, but just for whatever, the sake of the video, we kept him at left. Derek Brooks, who's regarded as one of the best cover linebackers in the history of the game. He had a perfect 99 overall in Madden 2004. I think he actually had a perfect 99 across multiple editions of Madden. I mean, this guy here, you look at his Madden All 25 team, like, his base card had like 95, 94 zone coverage. So he's phenomenal, very quick, and he's going to be a beast for us. I wouldn't be surprised to see him lead the team in interceptions. Middle linebacker, we have Barrett Rood, who in Madden 2011 had a 91 overall. He jumps up to a 93 in this scheme. He was a tackle machine there. For the Bucks, I remember back in the day, but a couple years ago, he was always fairly solid. Right outside linebacker, we have Lavonte David, who in Madden 15 had a 93 overall, and his scheme stays there. I think Lavonte David is definitely one of the more underrated linebackers in the NFL today. I think him and Quan Alexander have a great future ahead of them as the real backbone of the linebacking core there for Tampa Bay. Once they can maybe get Jameis Winston another weapon that's not Mike Evans, because they seem like he just fucking throws it to Mike Evans every time. I think that defense is ready to take off. In the secondary, we have Darrell Revis, who only spent like a year or two here. But in Madden 25, he had a 97 overall, jumps up to a 99 in this scheme. We all know what happened with Darrell Revis this year with the Jets. Real, real bad regression for him, but he still is one of the greatest corners in the Madden era that you could use. We also have Bronde Barber, who in Madden 2008 had a 95 rating, unfortunately takes a 2-point hit, but still a 93 for another guy that may lay claim to be the greatest Tampa Bay Buccaneer of all time. And then we have Brent Grimes and VH3 here, but Brian Kelly will be the other corner, who in Madden 2004 had a 90 overall. I've never really heard of this guy, to be honest, but he was a starting corner during the Super Bowl run, so that's probably why his rating's fairly high. Free safety, even though he played strong safety, just because I didn't want to have to deal with, like, switching all the positions, I will on the depth chart. We have John Lynch, he's a fucking GM now, the 49ers or something stupid like that. But John Lynch here, who in Madden 2002 had a 96 overall, jumps up to an 96 overall, jumps up to a 97 overall. Real, real good safety. I think it's going to be a real battle next year for if they go for one safety. Is it going to be John Lynch? Is it going to be Ed Reed? Is it going to be Brian Dawkins? You all know who I want to fucking get in there, but John Lynch definitely earns a Hall of Fame spot, one of the best safeties I've ever seen. And then a strong safety, we have, who actually was a free safety, Deshaun Goldson, who in Madden 25 had a 90 overall, and his scheme stays the same. Really had a big drop-off, but when he was in his prime with the 49ers, and then he went to the Bucks, he was known as one of the bigger hitters in the secondary. Kicker, we have Martin Gramatica, who had a 96 overall, a 97 overall in 2002 Madden. Wasn't he the guy like headbutt the wall, and then he was never able to play again or something stupid like that? I think there's brothers, too. There's Gramatica brothers that were kickers, but let's get off fucking kickers. And punter, we have Josh Bidwell, who in Madden 2007 had an 88 overall. So that's enough of the fucking roster. Hopefully, Coach Shots Fired can get us to a Super Bowl. So, yeah, what we'll do, we'll send him midseason, and then we'll play, just because we want this video to be decently length, we will play just the divisional rivals after the midseason point, and then hopefully we're making a playoff run. And then that'll be the end of the video. But I have to make sure this video is under 2 hours just for my own testing and shit. Because I think if they go over 2 hours, as I said at the top of the video, shit gets a little whack in terms of, like, you know, the analytics and it being me being able to manage the video and stuff like that. I don't know. Yeah, that was it. Gramatica tore his ACL trying to celebrate. He did something fucking stupid. That was before it was cool to tear your ACL while you're celebrating, like Stephen Tulloch and Lamar Houston. How many people does Aaron Rodgers fucking, whatever, double check? That little fucking wrestling belt thing? Hasn't that sent two guys to the fucking, to the IR? Have two guys taunted, like, making a play on Aaron Rodgers, and then they fucking went out for the season? I don't know. What do I think the Eagles' record will be next year? 9-7. I think 9-7. 10-6 would be the dream, but 9-7 would be what I have. So, perfect timing. How many games do we got left to play? We'll have to play the Falcons. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, yeah, 4 games ain't so bad. We can do that. We're 6-1, so that's looking good. Skip training. Play the moments. Thanks for saying that I'm a legend. Do you think Samaje Perine would be a good fit with Charles Sims, assuming Doug Martin will be gone? Yes, I think Perine would be actually a perfect fit because Charles Sims is a very underrated. I don't even know if he's underrated. Most people do think that he is a one of the better pass-catching backs in the NFL. So I think Perine, any big bowling ball running back would be great for the Bucs. You can get Donta Foreman, could be solid. James Conner, if you really want to hold on and get him later, James Conner would work. But I could certainly see where I just believe. I already said this in my draft videos. 3-4 years ago, every corner that was coming in the draft, everyone wanted the next Richard Sherman. Everyone wanted that big, long, rangy corner. Guys that were 6'2", 6'3", 6'4". I remember like a fucking bust, Stanley Jean-Baptiste, who went to the Saints. He got so much hype when he was coming out of Nebraska just because he was in that Richard Sherman mold. I think that is transitioning to the running backs. Everyone now wants to get a true pass-catching running back. Everyone wants the next David Johnson, the next Le'Veon Bell. So I think the big bruising backs, a guy that would definitely be someone the Bucs might look at, they may fall. I think I can see Foreman, guys that don't really have the best hands, slipping a little bit to the teams that just say, well, fuck, we just want our running backs to run. That's it. You know, we're not going to get put too much under their plates. But yeah. Do you think Nate Gary is one of the more underrated players in the draft? I think he's all right. I don't think he's really underrated. He's not really a playmaking safety. He's a reliable safety. But he's not bad. Where is he, Nebraska or Wisconsin? One of the two. Play action. Oh, wide open. There we go. Hit Adam Humphries. You think the Bucs need a better tight end or wide receiver? I think Cam Brate, you might be able to roll with him for another year. He was always worried with Cam Brate, the one-year wonder. Is he going to be like this year's fucking Gary Barnett or something like that? Because wasn't he like second in tight end touchdowns? But I think it's good enough for him to, especially you don't want to mess things up. Clearly, even if it is like a flash in a pan kind of season. You know, like tight ends with a quarterback, especially a young quarterback like Jameis Winston, that is a very good rapport to have, and you wouldn't want to mess that up by throwing another tight end in the mix. They might get like a little one in like the third round, maybe like an Evan Ingram or someone like that. But I think definitely get a wide receiver. I think Vincent Jackson he's probably going to be cut. I mean, if you're a Bucs fan watching this, I don't really know what value he has, and he definitely has a high cap hit. And you can't just throw it to Mike Evans every time. I mean, Adam Humphries started to develop a little bit. But for the most part, like the fucking second best wide receiver on that team seems like whoever is like the running back. So definitely think they should look at getting a wide receiver too. Maybe a guy that can stretch the field. I don't know what number they pick, but a D.D. Westbrook. I mean, if you can live with the there we go. If you live with like the somewhat off the field issues that D.D. Westbrook has, he'd be an excellent complement. They don't really have that unreal deep threat. That has like solid hands, so I think Westbrook maybe in the second round could be a good pick for the Bucks. John Ross in the first might be a little bit of a reach, but I mean a reach in terms of is wide receiver their number one priority in this upcoming draft. Why do I like the Gators? How many times have you touched yourself to a picture of Tebow the God? I have a Tebow jersey hanging up in this room right now. He is the greatest. I'm not a religious man, but Tebow is my God for sure for what he did in Florida. Oh, that's bad. How to become a Gators fan? Same, like, generic. I don't have any ties to any colleges in America. When I was playing football in high school, my aunt actually taught in Georgia, this great state of Georgia. So I was actually thinking about going to school down there, sending some tape off. I never had a whole lot of tape. But I was thinking about actually like going to the fucking guy that recorded the games, getting someone to make me up a highlight video, and send it to some colleges down there. I think as full-headed of myself as I am, I don't know what the third call. I don't know if I would have been good enough, especially coming from Canada. They're probably, Canadian football rules. Like Georgia and stuff like that would be unrealistic, even Georgia Tech. Like, what's the third team in Georgia? You know, the third team that's in Georgia. I might have had a chance of doing something there. I think the team called, was it Jacksonville State in Alabama? Was actually a team that when I did the scouting combine up here, a friend of a friend said I could probably send some tape down there. I think they're Div 2. But I didn't do anything. Plus, I always thought like that Jacksonville State was like an all-black college, too, when he told me about it. So I was like, yeah. So that could be a little awkward. Like, it was just probably some dude talking out his ass. But I have talked about videos in the past about me playing football. You can ask, like, now that I've got actually a little bit bigger, a couple of my friends. Like, before the average, it wasn't a secret, but I never really, like, promoted to my actual friends in real life that I did YouTube. But now that I've got a little bit bigger, they're like, hey, man, you do YouTube. So, like, I've actually seen a couple of them pop in the live stream. I don't know if they never tell me that they're in here. But I played football with Colin. A couple of the guys that have watched me was my quarterback. And, you can ask them firsthand. Like, I was a beast. I remember one practice. We actually had to stop practice and get me out because literally every time I touched the ball, our team was shit. I guess we could say we didn't win a single game, so it's not really patting myself on the back too much. I was just a lot more athletic than most of the players. But literally every time I got the ball, I'd score, get a touchdown. They just said, Corey, get the fuck out. We need to actually get some work going here. We need to practice. But I got hurt. I went to practice on my birthday, and I tore my Achilles tendon. So I sucked it. I didn't want to get surgery because it was my school's first year of having a football team, my last year, my senior year. So I was like, man, fuck this. There's no way in hell I'm sitting out this entire season by, you know, fuck. What we did, actually, was you make, like, how you kind of tape it up is you make an Achilles tendon with athletic tape. But I literally could not use, like, I had no speed. And speed was definitely my biggest attribute. I ran a 4.46, a 4.46, and a 4.49 40-yard dash at the combine, and I was 220 pounds. So, needless to say, I have got piss tested in my time in high school, but I could just outrun everyone, and it sucked because I straight up had no speed anymore. I was always in pain, and then luckily, I did get to play. I played the first snap, and the first snap, I absolutely trucked the shit out of a guy, but I've never played football before, so I knocked the wind out of myself at the same time as doing that. You know, it's as much as I want to say, hey, guys, like, ask my buddies. Remember the first play of our school's history where I got the ball on a pitch. C4 special, actually. And our wide receivers are horrible. They're, you know, everyone knows on a pitch the wide receivers are supposed to come in and block. They got blown up. But the guy, like, when I got him out in open field, he was already, like, bent over trying to tackle me. So I ran him over. But because I'm an idiot, I didn't fucking use my hands as protection. So, like, I ate it all in my gut. And I knocked the wind on myself. And then, really, after that, I just kind of played, like, a fullback blocking-ish role because I couldn't run anymore. But I did get good tape from my last game. The last game of the season, I was actually starting to feel a little bit healthier. And I don't know what I had. I think I had like 100, well, over 100 yards. It wasn't something crazy, but I think I had like 110 yards. And I remember, our team was shit. So we'd have constantly, I'd get like, CFL rules is you basically have two fucking chances to get a first down. And on third down, you punt it. So we basically running the ball all the time. It was kind of inefficient. And more often than not, we just would try to fucking kick a field goal. But I remember, I think I had like 120 yards. And we got right on the fucking 1 yard line. I was like, oh yeah, baby. Final game. First touchdown of the year. Fucking QB bootleg for the touchdown. I was livid. My buddy, he still brings it up to today. He's like, hey, remember when you fucking, your first game that you got to play? That touchdown that would have been excellent. Real sexy look on your tape. And I just fucking, there we go. Jeff Garcia's, that's a late hit. I stole it. Ugh. But I definitely, if, like, I don't know, like I said, I hate talk, people ask me all the time when they find out that I played football. Maybe one of these days I can bring on one of my buddies, and they can, like, talk for me, because I don't, like, anytime, I'm not a fool of myself person, and when I talk about how my stats, they are good, I feel like, oh man, this guy here is just living in the glory years, and he's fucking, you know, bragging and all that stuff. So I hate talking about stuff like that. That's why I don't go too much in depth. But I think, in my opinion, my heart was never in football. I hated football. I played running back on a shitty team, so I was constantly just fucking beat up after practice. And, you know, I never really enjoyed it. But I think if I was in America, if I grew up in America with what I was athletically, I probably would have been three, 4-star recruit. Definitely wouldn't be 5-star because I never read a playbook. I refused to play special teams, so I was kind of a diva. But I think bottom, even if Canada had, you know, scouting, I probably would have been a three-star, I would say, just because I literally never played football in my life. I could not run. Remember at the scouting combine, they wanted us to run routes out of the backfield, even like the running backs and wide receivers. I had no idea what the fuck I was doing. Like, for my school, because, you know, we were such a new school. Oh, my God. That's a flag. That's holding. That's holding on them. Because we're such a new school, literally, the quarterback, when he called the play, he'd just say, you're either running it, or I'm blocking it, or I'm catching it. So, yeah. My heart was never in football. I had an incredibly low football IQ, but I think from an athletic standpoint, I probably could have went somewhere in America. Don't know if I would want to do that, because I met my girlfriend at the time, and I don't really... When I was a kid, I was really good at soccer as well, and I spent some time away in England for soccer when I was, how old was I, 14, 15. I spent 3 weeks in England for trials, like trying out for teams over there in England. Went to like a Manchester United soccer camp, which like anyone can go. But then while you're at the soccer camp, you play against other teams, and there's scouts there and stuff. So I won the skills competition and all that stuff, and I hated being away from my family for that long. I didn't get homesick or anything, but it's just, I don't know. It's totally one of those things, like, I don't know how professional athletes do it, be on the road and away from people for that much. But that's enough about me. Let's jump right back in to the gameplay, because we've been not focusing on the right things. We need to get the victory. Oh, my God, he was wide open. Jeff Garcia, 91 overall Jeff Garcia. Can't make that throw? That's a joke. That's a joke, bruh. Why not use Vinny Testaverde subject? Jeff Garcia, the whole thing is I use the highest overall players, and Jeff Garcia has the highest overall for a quarterback in the history of Madden for the Bucks, which is surprising. I know, surprising to me. I would have thought Brad Johnson, probably. Usually they'll give like a couple sympathy points to the Super Bowl quarterback. You see that with, you know, Joe Flacco when we did the Ravens video. Let's end with a C4 special real quick. You ever try wrestling, CA4? What do you mean, wrestling videos? Like playing the fucking wrestling video game? Or professional wrestling? You met Kurt Warner today? Do you tell him that he fucking doesn't deserve to be in the Hall of Fame over Brian Dawkins? Which is highly debatable, to be honest with you. I think Kurt Warner for sure is a Hall of Fame player, but... With that, we won it! Big time victory over the Falcons. Close matchup. Jeff Garcia balled. Aired that shit out. So, what's going on with the Darrell Revis bullshit? They released Shady. LeSean McCoy got released. No way. No, he didn't. You're shit-talking me that LeSean McCoy got released, right? What? Revis got what? Okay, so no one, as long as no one knows. No, the Sean McCoy did not get fucking, no way. Oh, Revis got released. Okay, that makes a little bit more sense. I was like, there's no fucking way LeSean McCoy got released from the Bills. I heard that was a rumor, though. I heard people were saying that he might get released. He beat someone up? The fuck? Isn't like that guy's like? Don't you have like a posse with you that can handle with that shit? Like, so you don't have to handle that business yourself. You just get one of your fucking buddies to go make sure that stuff gets rectified. Turn himself in. What does America work? I know in Canada, you get a fucking slap on the wrist with something like that. He'd be out in like 2 days. Was he just so upset about how bad his season was last year that he just decided to like, yeah, you know what? Probably easier just to get arrested and go to prison. But like, he's going with the Aaron Hernandez approach to just ending his career. As we got to take on the Saints, we're 11-1, so we're looking real great here today. We got the creamsicle unis we can bust out. What do we got for Color Rush? I like those ones. We use these ones right now. Guys, check it out. Shady got cut. There's no way Shady got cut. I don't have time to fucking check my Twitter, which looks like I got 14 notifications right now, so. Some of you guys are probably just bullshitting. That's all you're doing. Alright. We're 11-1. We're looking real mint right now. Jeff Garcia firing all cylinders. His wife is holding out. If his wife, that's why he's playing so well. His fucking hot ass Playboy Playmate wife said, if you don't fucking win, if you don't get at least 13 wins this season, you ain't getting this. You know, you ain't getting no cookies all year. So, let's see what we can do. Worst crime can is bumping into somebody and not saying sorry. If you guys follow me on Twitter, there's a dude in Canada. You can Google it. It's called Vince Lee Greyhound Bus Murder. So what happened here was this guy, he had schizophrenia. This guy, schizophrenic, was on a bus. And then he just had an episode. He cut a guy's head off. He beheaded a guy and then started to eat him. And then he got arrested. But then because we're Canada, we deemed that he was schizophrenic and he didn't have any idea what he was doing. So he had no charges and he spent no jail time. And then a week ago, he's now released. He's released under the condition that he takes his pills. That's how fucking lenient shit up here in Canada is. Fucking, you can cut a guy's head off and eat him. And as long as you can convince that you're kind of fucked up, you can get out. So, I guess if I ever fucking feel like I need to go and murder someone in public. Oh, wow. Didn't mean to hit A. That was trash. That was embarrassing. That was really embarrassing. That ain't 11-1. I do need to, will I be doing a live stream during the draft? That is the plan, is for me to do a live stream during the draft. I don't know how it's going to work yet, but that's the plan. I really want to do that. I think that'd be pretty cool. Nobody got released. Thanks. Got fucking trolling over here. Defensive insanity is absolute bullshit. Honestly, is a bus in Canada a good place to live? Yeah. Definitely a good place to live. I love Canada. I would never leave Canada in my life. Soon we're going to have fucking legal weed everywhere. I'm not a big fucking Bob Marley fucking Buffalo Soldier. But having that for parties and stuff and not worried about getting busted, that'd be cool. Our dollar sucks ass, though. I'll tell you that. Dollar is absolutely terrible. That third best country in the world to live in? I think your stats, oh, come on. Oh, that's, oh, you motherfucker. I like living here, don't get me wrong. But third best, you have our problems. You can't get a fucking, good luck getting a job here. I'll tell you that. Horrible employment rate. Well, I guess that's kind of the story everywhere. There we go. Don't need to say it. Best field goal kicker on YouTube. What's wrong with our dollar? I have no idea what the fuck's wrong with the dollar. I'm not super in tune with the economy. But right now, one Canadian dollar is worth 65, 70 cents American. So, anytime I want to order shit, I ordered a Carson Wentz jersey. Fucking full price was, I don't know what the fuck it is. Real jersey is $150, something like that. It was $230 Canadian when I got it. So, sucks horribly to pay for things right now, which is why, making a trip to Philly. I was thinking, honestly, about going to Philly for the draft this year. The dollar is just so bad. It cost me fucking $2,000 probably to get there. But I really... We can't snort coke with our dollars. No, we cannot. It's a fucking gold thing called a loony. And it's, I don't know. I personally, being in America and living in Canada, the loony is better than a dollar bill. At least with a loonie, it's like a coin machine when you want to spend, buying pop and shit. Instead of having to, fold out a fucking dollar, and if there's a wrinkle in it, the machine won't feed it. So, I'd rather the loonie. We have a loonie and a toonie. Our $1 and $2 currency is in coin format. Oh, yeah, Kellen Winslow. Spinneroonie. If you could bring back any Eagles from before Chip cut them, who would it be? Spoiler alert, I'm thinking about doing that for a live stream. Every live stream is going to be different. I'm thinking about just making a one-off of what if Chip Kelly never came to the Eagles. So basically, it'd be current roster with Evan Mathis, Shady, DeSean Jackson, seeing what we could do. Like, it's not, you know, you're not really pushing the boundaries of creativity. But I don't know, I just thought that might be a nice little one-off. But so take these streaming things with a grain of salt, because they're not going to be consistent. They're going to be fairly inconsistent, I think. Oh, Cameron Brate, you bad, bad man. Cameron Brate just beat Troy Polamalu off the line for the first down conversion. What are we at here? 40 minutes. Yeah, we should be good. I have thoughts about moving to Canada when we graduate. I mean, depends where you live. You go to Montreal, if you can handle people speaking like a little bit of French. Half the people speak French. Most people speak French and English. But Montreal, sexiest women on earth. You know, much as it pains me to say that, and I'm a happily taken man. Every other chick in Montreal was slamming, and they're like, it's only Montreal or Quebec in Canada. It's a province. It's literally like, I don't know American law or America, how everything is broken up there in America, but you know, Puerto Rico is considered like a part of America, but they have different rules down there or something. Like, that's almost what Quebec is. Quebec straight up has different rules from the rest of Canada. Like, you can drink way earlier, I think. You know, you never get fucking IDs. Like, you're super lenient, and it's definitely the funnest. Oh, I almost go for the one-hander. It's probably the funnest province to go to. Why don't I ever play defense? I don't play defense because it makes the video so much longer. Like, I had to pick or choose how to condense these videos so that I could get them in not 4 or 5 hour fashion. And I figure, all right, we have to play one or two. And obviously, people want to see offense more than defense. So that's why I made that decision. If you want to see defense, you watch the Eagles Connected Franchise Mode and the Huskies Franchise Mode, where I have the defensive clips in there. Because I am just a dirty, filthy, casual defensive line user. Sorry, I learned it at a young age, and I just always... Actually, that's not even a lie. Back in the day, when there was good linebackers, I used to love the user, Brian Urlacher in particular. Oh, there we go, Kellen Winslow. But ever since then, the Eagles have always had good defensive ends. So, and I remember back in the day, you used to be able to pick an outside line. We can still do it, but it's not nearly as extreme. I remember between 2005 and 2007, Sean Merriman on the Chargers, he was like an 86, 87 overall left outside linebacker. You move him to defensive end, he's a 99, unstoppable. Like, just fucking finesse move past everybody. So that's kind of how I just got acclimated to that. So it's 4th and 5 on the 30, and they wanted to punt it? I don't think so. Where do you think Roman will be next year? I answered it yesterday. I guess you weren't here. I think, where should he go? We'll scramble for the first. I think Romo 100% should go to the Houston Texans. I think that financially he'd probably have to take less money than other potential options. But if he wants to win, I think Texans are a quarterback away from being a Super Bowl contender. So it'd be just smart. Plus you have like the whole storyline, like, oh, he went to another team in Dallas when the Cowboys didn't want him. And then, you know, the media can spin that into whatever the fuck they want. Remember when some big hits made the helmets come off? Yeah, remember when they used to have fucking jacked up, but then the league became so fucking sensitized that they... Oh, concussions, all that stuff. We can't have jacked up. Can't show off big hits. NFL used to be funner. I think you can care about player safety, but still highlight and show highlights of, you know, a very big selling point of the football, which is violence. It's like why I stopped watching hockey. As like a Canadian, people are always just like, you know, why don't you like hockey? Like, hockey's, like, there's barely any fights anymore. Every big hit in hockey now is fucking 5-game suspension. So, you know. Texas are in Houston, not whatever. You know the fuck I meant. I'm Canadian. I get a pass anytime I mess with you guys' geography because I guarantee you can't. Where's Moose Jaw? Tell me where Moose Jaw is, all right, you assholes. What do you think Moose Jaw is, you know? Tell me something about Canada before you try to grill me on what I know about America. Oh, great read. Hit Doug Martin across the middle. Muscle Hamster takes it up to the 15-yard line. think we're going for the victory here, Fort Bellas. We're not gonna suffer. I'm not going to suffer for too much longer. We're going to put them out. It's in Canada. Duh. Yes, it is. Well, what's that now? That was, that wasn't a legal pass. Oh, holding on the offense. Unfortunately, for those of you guys that were with me when I made a couple memes, when we did the Bucks rebuild, Kevin Pedophile is no longer a member of the Tampa Bay Bucks. We had to modify him to make, I think, Carl Nix, actually. Oh, why did you slide? Derek Brooks, greatest ever. Sing O Canada. I'll sing O Canada if you donate $40. I don't even think I fucking know my country's national anthem. That is one thing about America. You guys will never be beat for patriotism. When I went to the Eagles game, holy shit. We had to stand up like 9 times. Respectively, I know, I'm not never going to disrespect anyone like that. But like there was like fucking like an eagle. There's like 4 different anthems. We had to keep celebrating soldiers or something like that. Which, I mean, totally, like I said, soldiers are fucking the backbone of a country. But, I mean, nothing like we have up in Canada. You guys have us beat on patriotism. I guarantee, no shot at my girlfriend. She probably doesn't know the fucking words. And a big, you want to know something funny in Canada? When we're in school, the national anthem, you learn how to say it in English and in French. Oh, shit. Go for the tie. How bullshit is that? Imagine if you had to learn the, you guys had to, like, in America, do you guys have to learn the national anthem in English and Spanish? Probably not. It's because we do things up here in Canada a little bit weird. Oh, man, I better not fuck this up. Of course! Isn't that such the best fucking feature they ever added into Madden game? God, I hate that bullshit, man. Get that shit out the game. You're telling me that we can't have custom rosters, downloadable rookies, but you fucking add in that bullshit that no one fucking wants? Oh, that's stupid. So dumb. That is a loss, unfortunately. Well, I'll delete this fucking guy that's trying to spit hot fire. Come on, mods. Someone said, did I see the Bengal vid? Yeah, I talked about it at the very beginning. I think there's like a replay. For the rest of the first, like, 6 minutes, I kind of, it's not really giving my opinion on it. It's pretty much agreeing with what he said, because what he said was absolutely true. And I said I'm never talking about it, because literally, there's so much, like, it's one of those things, like, some people are like, man, you gotta let him say what he said and not make a rebuttal video. It's like, man, no, A, because there's nothing there, and B, I'd much rather make an actual fucking Madden video. I just want to fucking play football. And that's it. Fucking blocked extra point bullshit. But we're still 12-2. I'm gonna lie. We'll play the Panthers and then we'll go to the playoffs. You hope Trump builds a wall across Canada too? Why would you say that? That means I can't go to Philly and see goddamn Eagles games. All right, and that no one wants that to happen because next time I go to a game, I think I'll vlog it or something stupid like that. I don't know if I'll buy a fucking new camera or just use my iPhone. But I think I'm going to be going to the Eagles when they play the San Francisco 49ers in Philly. But I think I'm going to be doing that. I was kind of hoping when my buddy told me that was in San Francisco, because then maybe I can meet up with the legendary Eagles YouTuber EDP. Maybe ask him a couple things. But it's in Philly, but Philly's a fucking awesome city, so I don't know if I'm going, but I'm leaning towards going to that. David Johnson is the best RB in the NFL. 100% David Johnson. His fucking Madden overall rating is like a 92. No, he needs to be... David Johnson should be top 10 overall in Madden. He's unstoppable, like the biggest weapon in the NFL right now, I think. just because, obviously, him and Le'Veon Bell, you know, to each their own. But Le'Veon Bell has proven to be a fucking idiot in the off-field, students getting suspended and stuff. At least Dave Johnson's reliable. And it looks like he will be healthy to start the next beginning of the season. So, for all you guys up there in fantasy football world, he is the number one pick that you need to go and get. All right, let's do this shit. Let's get a victory here. Let's get a nice win before we jump into the playoffs. With, I might have to say Mike Evans is my favorite wide receiver in the NFL. Like, just going out of the fact that it'd be just stupid to say, like, I like, you know, I don't know. If you say, like, Antonio Brown and Julio Jones, you're like, oh, you just like the best player. So I think, like, for the next tier down, you get a little less slack for a little less flack for picking a guy. I'd have to say that has to be Mike Evans for me. Big fan of him at Texas A&M. Oh, shit, slide. He was a beast at Texas A&M. I think he single-handedly got Johnny Manziel drafted in the first round. There were so many times Mike Evans would make a play because Johnny Manziel was a little inaccurate and stuff. So I definitely say Dave Johnson is a beast. Who's my favorite tight end? I do like G-Reg with his third leg. I also like Gronk. Oh, shit. Carl Nix with the pancake block on 24. But, I mean, G-Reg with his third leg, though. Come on. If you guys have never heard the 7th Floor Crew song, go check that out. Oh, Mike Evans again. Am I playing Overwatch later? Probably not. I got an early morning tomorrow. It's fucking almost midnight my time. Might. I'm going to say probably not, though. I'll probably will play it. I think season 3 ends next week. So I will be playing at some point this weekend. Got to. Oh, come on. Make that fucking throw. I got to try to get into whatever the fucking the next tier that I need to get into. I think it's Diamond. But, yes, I'll be playing Overwatch some point this weekend. G-Reg, best rapper in the game. 100%. If you ever listen to the song 7-4 Coup, G-Reg has the best flow out of any of those guys. And I think one of them was actually a rapper. So G-Reg with his third leg, fucking busting that inner eye. He's hard as fuck. All right, we got 3rd and 2. Let's get it to the A-Train, Mike Allstott. About time we used him. And for Gronk, I mean, it's easy to kind of hate Gronk because he's on the... Okay, nope. We're going for with Allstott again. It's kind of easy to hate Gronk because, you know, he's everywhere. But I just think, like, if you told me I could play a game of Madden with someone in the NFL, he'd be up there for, like, most entertaining, I think. Him or Marshawn Lynch. Anytime you see that gamer skit that he does on Conan O'Brien, like, he's usually fairly funny. Okay, there's no way you're stopping Mike Allstott here. That's a first down. No way, that's a first down! We need a 1 yard. Okay, I'm going to challenge. Can I challenge that shit? How do I get out of this? That is a first down, ladies and gentlemen. Do I think the Panthers were overrated? I honestly have no idea why the Panthers weren't that good. I didn't watch enough Carolina. Go fuck yourself. That was a first down. Got goddamn Pete Morelli out there reffing the game. I have no idea. I didn't watch enough Carolina Panthers football this year to really say like why they were so horrible. I have no idea. It was literally the most surprising thing, I think. Like, most of the time, they're healthy, right? Cam Newton didn't miss too many games. I mean, Jonathan Stewart missed a couple games, but that's pretty much a customary. He's always been injury-prone. They had Kelvin Benjamin. They had Funchess. Like, everything was going... Looked like they didn't have too much injuries. Kuechly got hurt, I guess. But I just think they fucking... After that loss, when they got obliterated by the Falcons, like, that was it. Nail in the coffin on you. You don't recover from a fucking Julio Jones getting 200-some yards on you. Oh! Got rocked. Let's play a little bit more conservative here because we are in field goal range. C4 guys, go fuck yourself. Go fuck yourself! Do-do-do-do... Who's gonna be the best next? What? Who's gonna be the best team in college next year? It's probably Bama again. usually safe bet go with Alabama. It's so incredible, guys, that Alabama can do what they do every year with just getting every good five-star recruit. It absolutely speaks volumes to how good of a developing coach Nick Saban is. I mean, it must really take a lot of talent to get a fucking entire team of five-star players and manage to, you know, overcome all the odds and get them to the college football playoff. Really, really, really a credit to Nick Saban. Do you watch Gruden's camp, QB camp? Yes. Has it started yet? I wonder who's going to be on that this year. Well, obviously they're going to have most of the quarterbacks. Well, usually it starts like fucking. Yeah, you probably got another month or two to go before they start doing those. Ooh, Muscle Hamster. Battling on, he gets the first down. Where are we at here? Almost at an hour. I think next year will be Alabama, Ohio State, Michigan, Washington. Those would be my four, which is pretty much the same fucking teams it was this year. I think Washington is going to be really good. I believe in Jake Browning. I think he's a really solid QB. Oh, super linebacker bullshit. Miles Gaskin's a beast. They got Dante Pettis, McClutchin. Their defense, they got a couple guys. Vita Vai, or Vaie, I don't know how to fucking really pronounce it, but defensive tackle. He decided to go back. He's one of the best defensive tackles in college football. So I think they'll be fine. I think their secondary is going to take a big hit, and I'm not a big enough fan of them to know really what kind of depth they have, like who's going to be their next generation of corner. But I think Washington will be good. It's only like it's so easy to predict them to be good because they have the best defense. They're the only team that actually plays good defense really in the Pac-12. USC, I think USC will definitely be a sleeper team for sure. Penn State maybe. I think let's step up. Shit. I think Penn State could do all right because they might have, I think, what do you call it? Darius Geis and Saquon Barkley are probably, I don't know if it's a hot take, going on a limb. I'm not really thinking about anyone else. Might be the two most electrifying players in college next year. So I can certainly see if Barkley goes off, really, I don't know what Penn State's schedule is going to be looking like. But if Barkley is off, generational talent, man, I think, if Philly doesn't go after a running back, obviously it's thinking fairly positively that things can line up in place. I would love to see Saquon Barkley or Darius Geis in a Philadelphia Eagles jersey. So that's why, even though I'm sipping the Joe Mixon juice here, it's no homo, that I really would like Joe Mixon on the Eagles. If they don't really address a running back early this year, I would be fine with the assumption that, hey, okay, they didn't go after a running back this year. They must really want to get Geis or Saquon Barkley or someone like that next year. So, yeah. Florida's record next year, fucking not that good. We probably will still win the SEC East, but, man, we got to get a quarterback. It's embarrassing that we have not had even a decent, we have not had a decent quarterback since Tim Tebow, and that's been almost, what, fucking 8 years now? It's horrible. Absolutely horrible. We got, like, a nice-looking prospect in Felipe Franks. I think there's another dude at Florida. I can't remember his name or call his name off the top of my head. Like, Franks has the tools. Like, he's like a 6'6", 230 quarterback. But we need something. It's embarrassing. Like, Antonio Callaway, the wide receiver, he's really good. I can't remember the name of the running back right now off the top of my head. They have a Pirine. I think they have Samaje Perine's brother. They got a good tight end, DeAndre Goolsby. I think offensive line is solid. Great defense as always, even though there's always heavy turnover for the Gators on defense. Obviously Marcus May's gone. They're losing Quincy Wilson. They're losing Tease Tabor. They're losing Caleb Brantley. But I think they'll and Brian Cox. But I think they'll be all right next year. George Scarlett. Yes, George Scarlett. George Scarlett's a beast. I don't know why I couldn't fit his name. Like, he might be the best running back I've seen for. I think it's George Scarlett. I hope there's another one. Fucking Florida used like three running backs last year. But I'm pretty sure it was Scarlett. I had to do with the dreads. He might be the best-looking running back prospect I've seen in Florida. And that's, like, you know, get Jeff Demps. You got Matt Jones. You got Kelvin Taylor. I mean, it hasn't been great. Don't get me wrong. It hasn't been a bunch of... Oh, there we go. Jeff Garcia put the team on his back, though, in the fourth quarter. There hasn't been a lot of good running backs for Florida. But I think Scarlett might be the most talented. He has everything you want in a running back. I remember being a Gator fan, when the Redskins drafted Matt Jones real high, like a second, third round. I think it was second round. I was like, Matt Jones is not that good. Like, Matt Jones, at best, when I saw in college, was, you know, a running back by committee, at best, in the NFL. Let's see if I can see some other questions here. Yeah, okay, it was. Yeah, Jordan Scarlett. Yeah, Jordan Scarlett's a beast, man. He's going to be a good NFL player. Jeff Demps was a glitch. I remember in NCAA 11 or 12, Jeff Demps literally was unstoppable. He played like, the fuck? Oh, he was like some track star guy. He had like 99 speed, 99 acceleration. It was just a cheat code. Hit him with the C4 special back in the infancy of the C4 special days. Jeff Demps, whoo-hoo. Well, I think of Michigan, they're probably going to have the top defense again. I think for as long as Harbaugh, oh my God, rest in peace, Jeff Garcia. I think for as long as Jim Harbaugh is there, Michigan will always have top three defense. He's always going to have really strong recruiting. A lot of guys are going to want to play for him. That's the positive thing. I think if everyone, all the talk of Chip Kelly going back to college, I still think because he's in the NFL, having a guy like that so recent will really help you in scouting, because guys are just like, oh man, I want to play with a guy that was head coach in the NFL. Then again, oh, did he roll in for the touchdown? Fuck off. But, yeah, I don't know. I don't really – Michigan's one of those teams, I don't like them, but I don't know why I don't like them. I just historically have never been a big fan of Michigan. But there's nothing I dislike about them. Maybe it's because they were boring more often than not. They never have a good offense, so it's never really an exciting game to watch. And another fumble. Awesome. Jesus Christ. All right. I'm going for it. We're going. If the C4 special doesn't work here, I don't know when it'll work. Fuck kicking a field goal. Yeah, fuck that. Kick a field goal, we win the game. So we're going to do that. But I think Tyree Cleveland's going to be a star. I think he'll be, you know, probably as good as like DeMarcus Robinson. Like, he's probably good enough to make an NFL roster, but Antonio Callaway is going to be a star. Callaway is, again, you know, like I said, where Jordan Scarlett might be the best running back I've seen play for Florida, I think Callaway might be one of the best wide receivers. There we go. Close victory. Definitely an ugly game. Definitely focus talking more on the chat than actually performing in that. Who's better, Gurley or Gordon? Todd Gurley. I think Todd Gurley, if he had a great offense, if you put Todd Gurley, well, again, that's kind of a bad example because you put any running back behind Dallas. If you had Todd Gurley on the Eagles, for example, Eagles have like a, you know, depending on who you ask, a top 5, top 10 offensive line. He'd be probably, you know, top running back in the league, I think. I think Todd Gurley, it's everything. I think he's the perfect running back. I think where a lot of people are comparing Leonard Fournette to the next Adrian Peterson, I have the same kind of grade and feeling towards Todd Gurley. Melvin Gordon's solid, don't get me wrong, but he's no Todd Gurley. Tell you that forever. Michigan's offense is not bad. They're not good. Oh, we got 13-3 get a wild card. You can't say Michigan's offense is good. How many of those games there's just like the big talking point was how many points Michigan's defense and special teams was able to score. Their offense is definitely not good. I'd say it's not bad. It's not a bad. They're not shit offense. They're not like fucking Florida Gators. But that's a defensive first team. Always will be. Let's take a look here at the end of season stats. Jeff Garcia, 4,500 passing yards, rounding up. 37 touchdowns and 8 picks. That's not a horrible year. Running the ball, we got 1,500 yards and 11 touchdowns from Doug Martin. Cadillac Williams with around 600 yards and 9 touchdowns to his name. Oh, come on. No love to the A-train here in the sim. Receiving, Keyshawn Johnson led the team with 87 receptions, 1,000 yards, and 12 touchdowns. Vincent Jackson, 935 and 6. Mike Evans, 730 and 6. Kellen Winslow, the second, 645 and 5. And on the defense side of the ball, Barrett Rude led the team with 97 tackles. On the sacks front, we got 14 from Simeon Rice, 11.5 from Gerald McCoy, 8 from Michael Johnson. And for interceptions, come on, Derek Brooks. Aw, oh, I thought Derek Brooks would get it. He's not even on the list. Darrell Revis led the team with 6 picks, 3 for Lavonte David, 3 for Brian Kelly, 2 for Rondé, 2 for Deshaun. And Brooks all the way down here. The fuck? Why did Derek Brooks only have 33 tackles? Something ain't right. Did I fuck up the depth chart the entire season? Let's check this out real quick. Oh, Derek Brooks started. He only had 33 tackles. Okay, then. All right, let's jump right into the playoffs. How about AJ McCarron? Would he go to the Cards? No. Well, maybe. He's not horrible. How about Jim McElwain coming in clutch on signing day? For sure. I remember everyone on the Florida Gator Reddit was like, this is the worst signing day of all time. We have to fire Coach Mac. It's like, then he came in super clutch. We're definitely using these jerseys. Do I watch basketball or do I watch it at all? I watch playoff basketball. I don't really like regular season basketball. I find that once the game kind of gets out of hand, the team's just like, oh, we lost. We got to fucking play tomorrow anyway. But I really like playoff basketball for sure. My favorite teams are obviously the homer team is Toronto, but I'd say my favorite team is the Clippers. I've always been a big fan of Blake Griffin. The first year that I got into March Madness was when he was at Oklahoma. I'm pretty sure he went to Oklahoma. So I really followed him over from there. And then they kind of had that whole racist owner thing, you know, which is pretty racist, to be honest with you. So a little bit of a down period, a little dark period for the LA Clippers, but they're all right. Plus, like, for picking a team, they're, like, the worst. That's like me picking, being a new football fan, picking the Browns. Seems like the Clippers are historically, like, one of the worst franchises. So it wasn't like I was just jumping on a bandwagon. All right, let's go. Creamsicle Power. LSU thoughts. Until they get a quarterback, they're gonna struggle. LSU just never had. Who was it? Brandon Harris? Was that their quarterback last year? I know they got someone they switched up down the line. I like Ed Orgeron. I think he's a solid. He's just like one of those like entertaining guys. You know, they had Les Miles, used to fucking like eat grass, and then he left. But I think they replaced like a wacky character with a wacky character, which like, I don't know. I don't know if that's a prerequisite to be a head coach of the LSU Tigers. And I, you know, as a Gator fan, that's the other thing, though. I don't, whereas I'm an Eagles fan, obviously. I fucking hate the Giants. I fucking hate the Cowboys. I don't know. I hate the Redskins. Hey, Redskins are probably my least hated team out of everyone in the division. But for college football, it's all Alabama. Like, I don't really, as a Florida Gator fan, you'd assume I'd hate LSU. You'd assume I'd hate, oh, there you go. Beautiful. You'd assume I'd hate Georgia. I don't really mind them, to be honest with you. Like, I don't like them. Like, fuck Georgia, especially when Florida plays Georgia. I hate Tennessee. I'd say Tennessee and Alabama are my two least favorite teams in the SEC. Everyone else, it's just, I don't know, I take it or leave it. What do I think about next year's Florida-Georgia game? If Florida doesn't find a quarterback, Georgia, they got Eason. He's a good-looking quarterback. I think Florida's defense still could, that game will still be close. But I think it'd be a lot less close if we actually had a good quarterback. All right, what kind of time are we doing? Like I said, I got to make sure that this shit is fucking under 2 hours as a test for my channel. It's been a while since for those of you guys that didn't know, I wasn't able to live stream for like 3 months because of some questionable videos myself and my girlfriend did multiple years ago. I got a three-month ban from live streaming. So now I got invited to play Battlefield with my buddy Ed Facer. I might have to hop on and play that for a little bit. Sorry to the guy who wanted to play Overwatch. Not a huge Battlefield guy. I just play it because everyone stopped playing COD this year because COD is fucking AIDS. Boop, 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 doo. All right, let's see. Let's come back to the chat here. Remember when Florida was beating Tennessee 21-0? Yeah, I remember that. And then we absolutely fucking pulled a Kyle Shanahan in the Super Bowl. And I think the worst fucking called second half I've ever seen, I think, for a Florida Gator game. Do I think Wentz will pick out a good wide receiver in the offseason to help him? I already saw someone tweeted at me. He was working out with Cooper Kupp and Chad Hansen, two wide receivers that I have in the past mocked to the Eagles. So that looks, maybe that's something. Because the biggest thing about that, like usually it's a picture they work out in the offseason, whatever. They might have the same agents. But Carson Wentz, the Eagles front office, said they want his opinion on kind of players that they look at getting. So, I mean, Cooper Kupp in the second round, I'd be all over that. Especially, I mean, if we use the first round to get a corner, like a, obviously, Marshawn Lattimore is out of the Eagles' reach, more than likely. Like a Sidney Jones. I really would say Tees Tabor, Sidney Jones. Florida Gator bias aside, I do think Sidney Jones is a better scheme fit. He's probably the best scheme fit for Jim Schwartz's defense. He plays more zone than man. He plays a little bit of everything, though. That's like a big thing. It's kind of difficult to talk about the Eagles' secondary because really Jim Schwartz plays everything. He's not one set scheme for a secondary, but he does play a little bit more zone than man, and I think guys like Sidney Jones, a little bit undersized, would be a better fit. I actually wouldn't even hate Jordan Lewis. If we had Jordan Lewis in the second round, if he slips there, he'd probably be a good fit. But that being said, for the talk of Carson Wentz for a wide receiver, you might have to, you know, maybe he'll say, I mean, I worked out with Hanson, I worked out with Kupp. These guys are better than Nelson drops galore. Let's look at bringing them in. Will Quincy Wilson do well in the NFL? As a Gator fan, honestly, I thought he was going to be a safety. He's not. He's like the issue with Desmond King right now is that he's not athletic enough in the NFL to be a safety. They think he's, or a corner, sorry. They think that his hips are too tight. He's not quick enough. He's definitely probably not going to have the best 40-yard time. So everyone's like, Des King, he's definitely going to be a safety in the NFL. I see that with Quincy Wilson, to be honest with you. The same kind of things. He's not as, you know, not as athletic, but bigger guy like that, 210 pounds, I think he may better be a safety. I think a team that drafts him, they're probably going to be pretty fluid with his position. I think you might want to try him out at safety, but he's a solid prospect. I will say, though, as a Gator fan, for whatever it's worth, oh, what a catch, Keyshawn Johnson, ooh. I lost what I was saying, but yeah. Look at this fucking Adamito party. Give me a goddamn second, Ed. Eddie Menus. I gotta finish up this live stream. Let's see. COD gave me ass cancer. Yes, that is something that I've always played. Before, for like I said, a lot of you guys are new. This channel used to be everything. I used to play, well, I mean, still, sometimes you'll see the occasional Overwatch, but I'm trying to, I have a second channel. If you haven't subscribed to the second channel, it's still a work in progress. There's not a lot of videos being uploaded now, but I eventually want to put up just secondary games that I'll play, be it any old school retro games. I remember I wanted to play WWF No Mercy, some N64 games and stuff like emulators. Overwatch, if hopefully next year's Call of Duty isn't AIDS, I'll play a little bit of COD and put it over there. As Cam Jordan's having one hell of a first fucking, Jesus Christ, he's eating us alive. But yeah, COD, oh my God. This is the first Call of Duty I've never bought because I was like, man, gotta go boots on the ground. You gotta get rid of the microtransactions for guns. Oh, Keyshawn's a beast, man. Keyshawn is a beast. What's the channel called? It's called Beast Coast. It is, on the fucking main page of my YouTube channel. It's like in the sub box. I don't know if you guys know what the sub box is. It's in there. But like I said, it's hypothetically, everyone is like, oh my God, why is your name Beast Mode TV? Why is it C4? C4 is me. Beast Mode TV started out as me and my brother. And that's another reason why, I said I'm stopping talking about the YouTube beef. But, you know, I don't want to get my brother involved in things. He is, he'd probably spaz, honestly. Just this kind of personality is. But here or there. Me and my brother started this as Beast Mode TV. I was C4 and he was Daryl's Arrows. But then because Bad took off, we decided to make a secondary channel so that's where he could upload his stuff. He plays a lot of Overwatch. We might look at doing some stuff like that, live streams and all that. Yeah, that's an answer. People ultimately be like, why are you called C4? Why is this not called, you know, C4, not Beast Mode? That's an explanation. It was a channel that started off as me and my brother. And he's still around. Oh my God! Should have ran that shit. It's your boy, Robin Steele. Yeah, he's Daryl's Arrows now, motherfucker. Get right. Get right. But yeah, there's two of us. I wish he played Madden, because then that make my daily uploads a lot more easier, because we'd have two people doing it. But I still love you guys. Daily uploads ain't too bad. I have this weekend, though, a live stream coming up. Or not a live stream, it's called a live comm, because so many people, when I do my Eagles connected franchise mode and the Huskies connected franchise mode, you guys are like, man, I want to see your real reactions. Because I right now, basically, I edit the videos and then I re-record like the audio over top of it. So this weekend, there's a lengthy video. I think it's probably 40, 45 minutes. It's a live comm over the connected franchise mode. And I'm kind of going to see if that's the style that you guys like, because it's way easier on me to upload that than actually going through and editing the videos. But I don't have a problem editing the videos. It's just a trial run. Because that's the only thing that kind of sucks, because I knew that was always going to be a trial run. I had them pre-recorded for like a month, so I haven't been able to play any of my Eagles or Huskies connected franchise mode in over a month now, because I kind of had to wait for those videos to come out. But that is this weekend, so hopefully you guys enjoy that shit. As we are now in the divisional playoff play against the Green Bay Packers. You ever gonna play some other games, Ho? Like I said, secondary channel. I've learned. I tried to do things my own way, but then I learned when I put up videos that aren't Madden, people get upset. So I was like, fuck it. I'm making a secondary channel. I'm working on it right now, getting it partnered with my network so that I don't get hit with like copyright claims and all that shit. And once that goes through, you will see some other games going on there. Like I said, I'm going to look into, now that I got a little bit of spending cash to invest back in the channel. I'm actually going to look at, because right now my setup, I did a gaming setup. I think it's still up on the channel. So many people are like, well, you got to do something for your subscribers. Anyway, on my main TV, I have an Xbox One, Xbox 360, a PS2, and then on my other TV, I have a Sega Genesis, N64, NES, and something else. Fucking, what the hell's those over there? Anyway, I'm going to figure out a way to capture gameplay from all those old shit and play some other stuff on my secondary channel eventually. All right, let's do this. Let's get a W. Do I hate the Knowles? I don't hate them. I just like them, for sure. Definitely. I hate everyone ever hear of Bill Burr's bit on why he doesn't like Florida State. It's the fucking chant, man. It's the most garbage. Oh, hey, one out of bounds. Nice. Like, that's so annoying. I can't stand those games to hear him do that fucking, oh, ho, ho, ho. Every first down, second down, third down, fourth down, punt return. It's just over the top. I can't, like, I get a goddamn migraine trying to watch those Florida State games. But, wouldn't say I hate them. Dislike them, though, for sure. Hate is a word for college football that I reserve for Alabama. Like, I just know there's someone out there in the world that's favorite teams are Alabama and New England. And in that word, they also like a fan of the fucking Golden State Warriors. They probably like whatever fucking team won the baseball. Oh, come on, Vincent Jackson. V-Jax. Hey, Killcam, what up, bruh? I got so many mods. After this, I'm going to tell you, don't take it the wrong way. After this live stream, I'm going to clear out the mods, and then we'll set it up for the next. I have no idea when the next live stream. Honestly, it's one of those things. I have so many videos right now. Like, there's some stuff that's going to be happening that you guys will be enlightened on probably early next week. But right now for my channel, I already have video. Like, right now, any video that I work on is coming up in March. I have all February video. Everything is already scheduled. Every day has a video already coming out. So I'm already working on March. But that being said, because I have such, you know, I have some leniency, if I just feel bored one night, I will just live stream. So my live streams are going to be sporadic. There's going to be no set schedule. Eventually, there probably will be a schedule to them. Like before, back in the day before I got banned, I used to do them every Tuesday night. And then hopefully I can find like a nice set of mods. Haven't had a bad mod yet, but yeah. Definitely not as many people on. I remember like fucking yesterday, we had like 330 people on. We're doing this one like 3 hours later, and I didn't advertise it. And maybe Friday night, everyone's watching the fucking, isn't there like the NBA All-Stars things going on. But I don't really give a fuck. Like I said, these videos here, I hope this, because it's under 2 hours, it works. This is just an upload. I was going to fucking record this video tonight and just schedule it for another day. So there's no difference for me doing that and just kind of making it a live stream. Why did I get banned? I got banned because me and my girlfriend used to do a video where we talked about porn stars. And there's no nudity. We weren't breaking any. Here's what happened. Here's actually why I think it got happened. So we did that thing. I think it's because of my tags. I had like fucking actual porn tags, like porn sites, like Brazzers, Reality Kings, Bang Bros, all that shit. I think like a bot, because like the videos were up for 3 years. They're some of my most popular videos. They all had like 40, 50, 60,000 views a piece, and they're up forever. So I was like, man, these are probably fine. But I think probably YouTube might have changed something. They had a different bot scrolling, and I got fucking flagged. And then I had to, you know, I got one strike. And when you get one strike on YouTube, they remove your live streaming privileges for 3 months. So, yeah, my girlfriend's been kind of hesitant to come back and make some content on the channel. So I'll tell you right now, girlfriend, keep her. Totally down to be, she understands what she is. You know, I don't make clickbait with her, but I'll for sure shit make her wear a push-up bra, and I'll use that for the thumbnail. And she's down with that. She's DTF, you know? But the fact that, oh no, why did you throw that? Idiot. The fact that I got banned for that shit, though, was pretty weak. I figured it was either a bot that found me or someone just got really salty and didn't like my stuff and tried to get me kicked off YouTube, because then I had to fucking panic. Oh, it's holding on them. Thank you very much. I had to panic and, like, take all those videos down. It sucked. I lost, like, 500,000 views taking all those videos down. But it is what it is. Whatever. Go hut hut. Oh my god, offensive line has been letting me down. I can't wait till I do one of these fucking legendary rosters with a great offensive line. Who do you guys think will probably have the best offensive line in the Madden series? Dallas, New England. So that's gonna be. Oh my, like I have no time. That was fucking When will I do a face reveal? My face is already on the channel, bro. Go look, type in C4 Vlog. All summer, I would just fucking get my phone and talk about Eagles news that was happening during training camp and free agency. Only reason why I don't do face cams now is because the render time from when a video doesn't have to have an overlay from a webcam on it to when a video has it, it's almost like an hour. So for the fact that I just want to try to go with the best time management for making videos. Plus, it's not really, like, what the fuck? You guys want to see me just swearing? So, but my face is all over the channel. My girlfriend, if you want to, for those of you fucking creeps that want to see my girlfriend, I think there's two videos of hers on the secondary channel as my offensive line is falling apart. I think we're going to need to change up the snap count here, ladies and gentlemen. How often are you going to stream? Ideally, if time permit, it's twice a week, probably. 2-3 times a week. I mean, last night I got, like, almost 50 fucking bucks doing this. I'll never ask you guys to donate money. But I got 50 bucks. If I get fucking money every time I do this, I'll stream every day. But, I mean, it's not always going to be like that. You're not always going to have the super fucking generous people. But, like I said. Look at this guy. Connor Flight. This is the same motherfucker that donated like 10 bucks. Where are my Bears? Getting some love on the channel. I'll tell you, I scheduled this morning the Bears episode of this. So the Bears legendary Madden roster is coming the first week of March. Unfortunately, because I have to schedule my videos and stuff like that appropriately, it is. Because the worst thing is double uploads. I remember the other day I did. First of all, thanks, Connor, for the money. How does this work? Like, you're giving me 20, like. Okay, never mind. These are the people that donated yesterday, right? That's how it works. Okay, good. I'm not going to say. That's, okay, sick. No, I'm pretty sure it's because these guys donated yesterday in my stream. I don't think you guys re-donate. If you guys re-donate, then you're fucking crazy. I'm going to tell you that to your face right now. But I'm pretty sure it's because you guys donated yesterday in the Super Chat. So thank you guys for coming back. But yeah, the Bears is already done. I recorded it this morning, and it'll be coming out first week of March. And welcome back, Devon. Devon Wilkinson. Devon, I don't know. Like I said, so many people make fun of the way I say people's names. I hope I didn't butcher that. Thank you coming back to the Super Chat. I don't know what the fuck that is. I guess it makes you better than everyone else. Come on. This is always going to be a tough one. Because for those of you guys that don't know, this Green Bay team is already juiced. This is a Green Bay team that is filled with, you know, all the Madden legends already. We usually come across these teams once we make the playoffs. And the Bucks team is just not as good. Like, we got, like, what? No one open. Fumble the ball. At least we're able to pick it up. Make her wear a push-up bra. I made her wear a push-up bra. I fucking told her to put on some makeup. I said it respectively. I mean, you know, we've been together 7 years right now, so we know how it works. We know how the game works. Ah, fuck. We got to punt this. She's down for it. She understands. She's like, all right, these little horny kids want to watch my video. Okay, cool. She'll just be like, make sure you monetize that video there. C4. She calls me C4. Devon. There you go. That's what I thought. Devon. I played football with a Devon. That's because you're a super chat. I'm going to make sure I don't butcher your name. But yeah. She's like, as long as you monetize videos I'm in, I don't give a shit. So she's pretty much, I pretty much pimp her out, I think. The fact that she will only do videos that I make money on. And yeah, all that stuff. But it's a great relationship we have, really, in all honesty. We're getting absolutely body bagged here, guys. The stream is pretty much going to be wrapping up here in a second. Sorry for those of you guys that just kind of came back. Do you think the Bears or any team should give a first-round pick for Garoppolo? I think all of the teams should give a first-round pick. If you're hurting for a quarterback, Jimmy Garoppolo is better than any of the projects that you may have to draft. I think Garoppolo is a better pick. He's going to be a better player next year than Trubisky, than Watson, than Deshaun Kaiser, than Patty Mahomes, Davis Webb, all those guys. So I think that if you want a quarterback, if you can only get, you know, as long as you don't have to give up a king's ransom to the Patriots, because heaven forbid, give them a bunch of ammunition that they can use to draft with. I totally think that the Bears, they really want to. See, that's the thing. Bears have number 3. Unless they can find a way to trade down from number 3 and then trade something later, I don't think Garoppolo's worth a 3rd overall pick. But I think for a team like the Browns, 12th, yeah, go for it. Oh, my God. Look at this. They are shutting down every fucking play. We're getting bodied. We are getting absolutely bodied right now. Covered sack out of the 10. What do I think about Raekwon McMillan? Solid. I think middle linebacker is not the strength of this year's draft, but he's good. I don't think he's as good as Zach Cunningham. I don't think he's good as Reuben Foster. I don't think he's good as Jerrod Davis. But he's probably, you know, top 5, borderline top 5 middle linebacker. So we're going for the onside kick. This game's fucking done. We'll start wrapping up this trade. It kind of sucks that the 2 Super Chat guys came in as we're wrapping this thing up here. But if things go well, I might stream tomorrow night as well. I don't know what video I would stream tomorrow night. But potentially. I'm not going to, you know, yesterday I said I'd be for sure streaming tonight. I'm going to try to stream again at least some point this weekend. Just to get back into things, let everyone know that I'm back live streaming. But, yeah. What I think about I don't have a vlog channel. There's just, like, search for my videos. I think just, like, C4 Vlog. Like, that's the title of the video. What about TJ Watt? I think TJ Watt's solid, but he's an outside linebacker. He's definitely, I don't think he's an inside. That 6'4 safety out of UConn? Yeah, OB Melnifanu or something crazy like that. I think he's gonna fucking destroy the combine. Like I heard people saying that he's gonna have, like, you know, fellow UConn teammate Byron Jones. They're saying that he might have like some eye popping numbers like Byron Jones had. So Kellen Winslow making a play. But Josh Harvey Clemens, he's good too. I think he might be I don't think he's athletic. The Obi, we'll call him Obi. I think Obi from UConn. One of his strong suits is his athleticism. I think Josh Harvey Clemens is athletic enough to play safety. I think he might move to linebacker. But definitely saw it. We saw Josh Harvey Clemens. He's a beast in our Toronto Huskies connected franchise mode at safety. Can't wait to the next rebuild. I think it will be next Friday. I don't know. The end of the finale, the whole thing with the 49ers, it was the finale. I'm not exactly sure if I'm going to take a week off or not, as that's almost picked. But I guess I can leave the spoiler right now. Is the first one, the opener of Season 2, is going to be the Carolina Panthers. I already know what I'm doing with them. So that is a little bit of a hint for all you guys. Do you think I think the Titans for sure can win the AFC. At least their division. I think they're gonna be the team that's gonna get super hyped this year. Like where last offseason was the Jags and Raiders. I think this year it's gonna be the Titans and probably people assuming the Panthers will rebound. Top receivers in the NFL. I don't know. I'm not gonna come with a hot take. It's fucking Julio Jones, Antonio Brown, Mike Evans, all those guys. We were able to get a nice little touchdown here. Taunt in Nick Collins' face. Kellen Winslow with the touchdown. Too little, too late, though. We're going to fall out here in the divisional round of the playoffs, which absolutely sucks. It sucks. The Texans will happen in Season 2. I'm telling you that right now. But we're going to wrap up this stream here. It's under 2 hours, which is exactly what I was trying to go for. A little spur of the moment. All you guys asking questions, all that shit. I'm going to try my best to stream again at some point this weekend. But thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you for all that. I'll catch you guys at a later date. So in this video here, we did the newest episode of the greatest players in Madden history, featured with Tampa Bay Bucks. We kind of talked at the very top about the whole Bengals situation and, you know, why it's absolute fucking nothing. Yeah. Catch you guys on the next one. Peace out, Bob Ross. You better fucking, next time I come here, make a painting of me fucking Kim Kardashian with J-Lo licking my nuts. That's all I know. All right. Catch you guys later.